Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter Chemical Equilibrium, and we are doing the topic Reactants and Products. Hello friends, now we are going to talk about the new chapter, that is Chemical Equilibrium. But before understanding chemical equilibrium, we should understand what is actually chemical reaction. And whenever we talk about chemical reaction, always the two concepts that comes in our mind, and those are reactants and products. So what are reactants and products? Let us talk about them. So now let us understand what is reactant and what is product. So before understanding reactants, let us understand the definition of it. So it says that when one or more substance which reacts and undergo a chemical change are called as reactants of the chemical reaction. So that is the main thing that we are going to learn about, what are called as reactants. So those substances, they interact with each other so as to form a new kind of product. And those substances which are interacting with each other, that kind of the substance are basically known as the reactants. And yes, moreover, it should give a chemical reaction. And what is actually chemical reaction? Chemical reaction is a transformation of a particular compound or of a particular substance made up of a certain kind of molecules, and that has been converted into another kind of or new kind of product after the interaction of that. So that kind of the reactant species are basically known as the reactants, or those who interact with each other so as to form product. So that is what we have got to know about the reactant. And now, what are said to be the products? So product means the new substance formed during the chemical reaction between the reactants are called as the product of the reaction. So because of the new substance that we have formed because of the interaction of the reactant molecules with each other, and it is not necessary that the reactant molecule should be two, it could be three also, and it could be multiple reactive molecules would be there, so as they could interact and they could form a particular product. So that is the main thing, that they form product because of the interaction of the reactants. But the main thing is we have to provide a particular that is condition also. So there are few reactions which require particular condition, while the one which can react in normal room temperature also. So that is the reason that understanding chemical reaction is very important, because nowadays what we are doing is we are converting a particular substance into another substance, so in a kind of a chemical reaction or in a kind of chemical transformation. So it is better to understand that which one should be acting like a reactant and which one could be formed as a product. So that is what we have got an information in this case. So let me give you a short analysis that how the reactant and the products are being represented during a chemical reaction. So this is already we know, but let us understand that too. Suppose if we have, that is a methyl chloride. So that is a CH3CN, and suppose if I am reacting it with that of a kind of KOH, and this is an aqueous solution of KOH. So in this case, basically these two molecules are different molecules, and that's the reason that there would be an interaction with the two molecules that we could see over here. So there would be kind of an exchange of the atoms, or there could be substitution, there could be kind of we could say elimination, and there are different kind of reaction that we have did in our lecture, that is some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry. And so this is how the reaction will happen, and that's the reason that we could form a new kind of product. So in this case, basically you could see that the methyl chloride has been present, and in this case basically the potassium hydroxide has been present, or we could represent it in this way. So if you mix this, then we can get a new kind of substance, and that kind of new kind of substance are basically known as the product. So this arrow indicates that they have reacted with each other and they are forming a new kind of substance, and basically known as product. So therefore we could get basically CH3OH plus KCl. So because these two have interacted with each other, and that's the reason, so as to form a stable product, that's the reason that these are known as reactants. Well, this is the new product that has been formed because of the interaction that has occurred over here. So therefore this one could be called as products. So the reactants and products are being related to, that is, chemical reaction only. Suppose if we have a particular compound with us, and that is suppose an methanol. So methanol is the one that is already with us. So there is no chemical transformation that it has took place from during a chemical reaction that we have took, suppose, different to a chemicals, and from what we have got, that is a particular substance, that is methyl, a desired substance, that is methyl alcohol. So methyl alcohol is already suppose it is with us, so we cannot call it as a product, but that could be utilized as the reactant. So the product or the reactant, they would, these are the two concepts that will be related to the chemical reaction only, and that is what I have talked about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood that what is reactant and what is product, and share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.